Governor Cuomo reassured New Yorkers the state is preparing for the worst.
No one is going to attack New York unfairly, and no one is going to deprive New York of what it needs.
To that end, a field hospital is being set up in Central Park, Mount Sinai, in partnership with Samaritan's Purse. A humanitarian aid organization will set up 14 tents to accommodate up to 68 patients. This in addition to the 4,000 beds at the Javits Center that will be opened this week, and the 1,000 beds on the USNS Comfort, which will dock at Pier 90 on Manhattan's west side at 11 a.m. on Monday, all to help our already struggling medical facilities.
Our emergency rooms are about twice as filled as usual. Our intensive care units are about three times as large as usual.
To contain the spread, beginning Monday, the NYPD will issue fines ranging from $250 to $500 to those who are not properly social distancing. They will be monitoring parks and playgrounds.
Now it's as simple as this. If someone is told by an officer, disperse, keep moving, you're not distanced, and they don't follow the direct instruction from our officer, or they say they're doing it and then they come back right away, I'm comfortable at this point that they will be fined.
Mike Franzone, who's an essential worker, snapped this picture of a packed 7 train during rush hour on Friday.
There were a lot of people who were not practicing proper PPE. There were gloves, they were touching, no gloves, they were touching the rails. You know, there were people with no masks on, and it just, you were in such tight quarters.
The mayor said the city is aware of some packed subway cars, and they're working on it.
We are going to work together, the MTA and the NYPD, to go and do spot checks.